episode. Just like last week, we're having guests on the show, and this is Uche, which is an A&R. Also, Uche. And this is Rida. Rida is a music critic. What's up, Rida?
Set of five. We call for the.
Alright, guys. I've wanted to always talk about this. Rap scene in Nigeria. Jayco was in the country about some time ago, and the response to the kind of.
You happened to meet.
Nah, I would love to, but then, nah. But it was in Nigeria some time back, and then the response to the rap genre was mind-blowing. We all thought it would come and not a lot of people would be able to vibe to J-Cole, but then it was like half the crowd, or almost everybody in the crowd, were singing along to J-Cole. So it shows that people actually like rap music in this country. But what exactly is the problem with the rap scene here in Nigeria? Because I don't think we all vibe to rappers like that in this country. You get my point?
I think the main problem with Nigerian rap is most rap artists are not rapping. Most Nigerian rap artists are moving into like the hip hop, and they're not focusing on rap itself. And most Nigerians, the majority of them, don't listen to rap. Most of them just they prefer hip hop, dancing.
They listen to rap.
Nah, most of them do.
I just feel like exactly what she said. If we're trying to get all the audience as possible.
Yeah.
It's not like we don't want to be in that box where that Mode 9 space. You remember that Mode 9 era where he was just doing street rap. And he wasn't even really giving a fuck about had people so and he had his own crowd, and I just feel like if you are going to do your stuff, just do it and be true to your sound.
But there are some rappers that are true to their sound. There's Boogie came out as an hardcore rapper, and he has been an hardcore rapper all day. We have a lot of rappers that are like that, but it makes me think, is it the content or the way they push the song? Because when you listen to rappers like J-Ho, they've got something peculiar to them. When Tyler the Creator is rapping, you notice the anger in him towards his father. He has an image in his rap music. Most of our rappers don't even have something to rap about. They don't have what they don't have a drive. It's just bars, lyrics, bars and bars. You get my point?
I just feel in Nigeria, in America, it has been that culture since. Had that rap culture, they've grown on it, and a lot of people have come and say, okay, we are rappers, we are street rappers, and they sort of had that niche to themselves. But in Nigeria, you notice that hip-hop is selling, reggae is selling and stuff. So if you want to tap into other people's audience, you have to find a way how to
infuse rap
to hip-hop and not just be left aside.
Yeah,
and that's just how it is.
But a lot of rappers have switched up. A lot of rappers have switched up. YC came out and I was like, yes, this is the rap desire. But then he switched up. MI came out with the song that you rappers should fix up. And I feel like, yes, we should fix up. Do you think we should fix up?
And you know, if you notice, MI at some point, he wasn't really growing up, like when he was coming up to us to become an established rapper. He wasn't like a rapper.
He wasn't hardcore rap. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
So and I it's just still that face of him saying, okay, I'm not going to do this. I'm going to keep up to my. And he got to a point where he was also doing getting other people from different genres to feature. I just feel it's just like it's a good process.
You feel like that too?
Because you see, when Dremel came out, Dremel
was
a rapper.
It's basically what sells that people want to do. Hip hop sells, and hip hop sells way more than rap. That's why people are
buying it more. So it's worth selling.
But I just feel as time comes, we'll get to know the true rappers, and we'll get to know
my point exactly. You have to be extremely good.
Extreme, my point exactly.
And when MI said you rappers should fix up your life,
Exactly.
He was talking about, he wasn't really talking about the current rappers. He was just telling people that, oh, that you come and say, hey, MI, please help me. MI, this, help mm-hmm. me, sign me, this. He was like, yo, when I started, I didn't start with
any
connection and everything. I stayed true to my craft and I established myself. Fact. So, yeah.
All right.
So, thank you guys for coming. Maybe that was fun, which is thank you for coming. I appreciate it. All right, guys. So I'll see you guys next week with some more vibes.